Hello everyone, this is the TechBoost channel and today I'm going to tell you about my dream phone for 2013, how it's going to be made and from where it's going to get its hardware and software cues. First things first, the design. There are plenty of great designed phones, though I like the design to be taken from the Moto X because it's very comfortable and easy to hold, but I want it to be made by Oppo because the build quality of their phones is just outstanding. I think that the dream phone's display should be made by LG or Samsung because they make the best displays on the market. They are high res, they have very good color reproduction, outstanding viewing angles and great outdoors visibility. In the hardware department, I prefer the phone to have front-facing speakers like the HTC One's Boomsound. I want Motorola to make the battery because it is the best player in the battery field. And I also want Motorola to make the mics because they make the best mics. And I want the storage to be at least 32GB plus micro SD card slot. Let's move on to the camera, and the best camera this dream phone could have is the Nokia Lumia 1020's Pure View sensor. Or, just to keep the price lower, it should have a 16MP sensor with ultra pixel technology from the HTC One for great low light results, and optical image stabilization to allow longer shutter speeds for even better low light performance. In the software sector, I would like this phone to have the latest version of SoC Android with Ubuntu desktop from the Ubuntu Edge, so you can use it as a smartphone for a while, then use it as a desktop replacement. As I said in a previous video, performance is a result of both good hardware and software optimization, and I like how the Moto X's X8 mobile computing system that packs an older Snapdragon S4 Pro performs really great thanks to optimization, but this phone needs to run a desktop operating system alongside with a mobile one. So we should learn from the way Motorola built the X8 chipset. It has different cores for different kinds of processes to save battery. And I would like the dream phone to have separate CPUs for each of Ubuntu OS and Android OS. It also needs 3GB of RAM or more and a Tegra 4 or Adreno 330 GPU to have a flawless performance. But to have a phone like this, you need to make a compromise, and the compromise is going to be in the price. Expect a phone with these specs to be priced a little bit like a high-end tablet. So, there you have it. This is my dream phone for 2013, and if you are a phone company, please manufacture it and make it affordable. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel.